I mean, where the f- should I really even start? I got that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my across the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that
it's Bungie today. We are back here with another video. And today's gonna be a vlog. I don't really do vlogs on this channel, but today is gonna be a great one. And there's gonna be way more vlogs in the future. And I will be meeting an NBA player at the Basketball Hall of Fame. Guess who it is? Just think. I'll give you one hint. He jumped over Shaq. If you know who he is, it is. I don't know if I'm saying this right, but I think it's Hamidou Diallo, who won the dunk contest. I'm gonna see how I pronounce his name, but I think it is Hamidou Diallo. So yeah, so today I will be meeting him, and we'll see how it goes, and today's just gonna be a vlog. So I'll see you guys when I get back.
So I am back, and yes, I was right. It is Hamidou Diallo, and as you guys can see, I'm having a tasty breakfast sandwich right now. Some juice, whatever. I don't care. But so yeah, I'll see you after I take a shower. I'm gonna show you when I get my hair, and then we'll just go on from there. So I'll see you guys in a little bit. Okay, guys. So now I'm going to do my hair so I can get. All right. So if you guys know how I do my hair, so I already wetted it. I put like moisturizer and stuff already. I don't think I'm gonna make this a long part. I'm probably gonna time lapse this. But I'm just gonna do the curl brush. It's pretty simple if you guys know what a curl brush is. You just go all around. So yeah, it's pretty much it. So I'm gonna be time lapsing this. So yeah. So I'm back. We just drop off my sister at my grandparents' house, and now we will be going to the basketball hall. About to enter. Okay. So we're about to enter the Basketball Hall of Fame. So yeah, I'll see you guys when I get
there. Becoming the best team we can be. It builds character, but it also reveals what character you have.
Their hearts cannot possibly be bigger.
Just the energy around it. It's a flat out addiction.
I love basketball. This is our game.
I think it's beautiful to watch in a locker room and a team.
Friendly entertainment here at the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame underneath the watchful eyes of all of the Hall of Famers above us. Some days that means you can come and learn to play hoop with the UMass basketball team. Other days that means skills clinics. We have one of those tomorrow. Other days that means you can meet Hall of Famers. And today you get to meet a slam dunk champion. Not just any slam dunk champion. Now, I teach at Springfield College, where we invented the game of basketball. But my guest, a native of Flushing, Queens, he played his prep ball right down the road at Putnam Science Academy in Putnam, Connecticut. He is the third consecutive dunk champion to join me here at the Springfield I love it because there's so much territory to cover. You've done so much already. But then there's still so much ahead. So I want to go all the way back, if you don't mind, to Queens. You're a Queens guy. Your game is about as New York as it gets. And I love that about it, right? I mean, you can tell when a guy's Philly ball. You can tell when you're playing with a, and you can really tell when you're playing with a New York baller. And, you know, you played in your Corona neighborhood. You're a Lafrak City guy. Can you talk a little bit about the way that your childhood helped to shape you, not only as a man, but also as a baller?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like growing up in my neighborhood, basketball was my only outlet. So each and every day, that's all I pretty much knew how to do and when to do it. It didn't matter. But I always was walking around with the basketball. And many people say, I mean, you gotta keep chasing your dreams, keep chasing your dreams. But I chased my dream for 20 years for me to actually achieve something and feel like, wow, I really accomplished something big, and for my family and parents to be happy for me, so.
It's really exciting. When their star, do you think that maybe your experience as someone who could look up to those two guys would be different than someone who didn't have a couple of NBA guys who came out of their neighborhood? Did you actively chase their star? Were you really trying to do what they did? Did you seek them out?
To be honest, I never really thought it was possible.
Really?
I mean, just growing up, Kenny Anderson, Kenny Smith, I mean, those were like household names.
Yeah.
And for you to be a kid playing basketball, saying you want to be Kenny Smith and Kenny Anderson is like, man, you and all the other 500 kids.
Yeah.
So it was like, because nobody ever had to leave. So you just gotta keep working and just put your mind to it and put your best foot forward.
You're a guy who worked your tail off in public school and found your way. In fact, it wasn't until about 2015, that summer, with your Jayhawks AAU team, that things, that your star really began to rise. And then you find your way down to Connecticut, to the Putnam Science Academy. You played at the Mason, at the Hoop Hall Classic. It was the first time I saw you play. I'll never forget it. Give me a sense of that decision for a guy who was so dedicated to your home to then choose so rooted in his home.
Yeah, definitely it was difficult, but I just felt like it was something that I had to do to accomplish the goals that I wanted to accomplish, because living in New York City, they just put it in a nutshell, and it's like, oh, you're only gonna reach this certain ceiling, and you can't do this, you can't do that. But I always thought I was better than every player that I played against, no matter like what ranking you was, who you was, what offers you had, or what school you was going to, I always thought I was better. So I just felt like I needed a better platform, and that's what Putnam Science Academy gave me. And once they gave me the platform, I never looked back.
Never looked back. PJ Washington. And being recruited in 2015, 2016, 2017, it's not like it was for guys who came a long time before you, because thanks to social media, you know these guys. You know Kevin, you know PJ, you know Shaquille Alexander, you know Kevin Knox, you guys know each other. Was there a level of excitement as you were one of the last ones to commit. Was there a level of excitement as the four of you were starting to realize what you could build towards the next year?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like it was more of us recruiting each other.
Yeah.
So I think the first person to commit was Claude A. Green.
Yeah.
And once he committed, I knew I wanted to play with him, so I committed. And then Shea committed, and then PJ committed, and then Kevin was the last one to commit. I mean, we just all really wanted to play with each other, and we felt like that was the platform for us to go show what type of players we were.
It is among the most crazy draft nights. As a total hoop nerd, watching you go 45th overall to Brooklyn, then to Charlotte, then to Oklahoma City. I have two questions. One is, can you take us through all the emotions of that night? And the other is, did you get to keep those hats?
Yeah, I got to keep the Brooklyn hat. And they let me put on the Charlotte hat because the trade happened so fast.
Yeah. So what was that like emotionally for you? To see Brooklyn had to feel real special. But then to have all of that chaos. Did your agent let you know that all of this was going to happen? Or did it feel like the movie was moving too quickly at that point?
The movie was moving very, very fast. I mean, I got drafted 45th. I walked across the stage. Now my family meets me in the back. I'm taking pictures with the Brooklyn hat. And my agent pulls me to the side like, hey, take the hat, I'm gonna bring you another hat right now. And I'm like, what? I'm like, what are you talking about? He's like, oh, you go to Charlotte. So I'm like, oh, okay, so we stopped taking pictures for a little bit. And now the guy's bringing the Charlotte hat. But he said that just take one picture, we didn't give it back. I'll take a picture with your family. So I've never seen the picture of Lena Charlotte hat. Never. And then he brings an Oklahoma City hat. And it's like, you can take pictures with this with your family, but you can't keep it. So I don't have an Oklahoma City driving that hat. But
That's interesting. Like, we need that.
The league has to put you in it. Want you to be in it as well. You can want to be in it so much, but if nobody wants you in it, you're not going to be in it. I was a late addition, so a player got hurt, and then he was looking for an extra guy to pick up, and they picked me up.
It worked out pretty well.
Yeah, rest in peace.
What is it about? I often, you know, this is, as I mentioned in your intro, now you're our third consecutive dunk contest champion that's met here the 60 Days of Summer. Donovan Mitchell, Glenn Robinson III have been here in the past 2 years. And I love asking them this, so I'm going to ask you the same thing. What about that event speaks to the way that you play? Is there something, because you could argue, I think fans of a certain age are probably like, how many more dunks can they really do? But then they watch you and like the artistry is there. So what about that event speaks to your style?
I mean, you just have to be creative and you have a certain swagger and approach about the whole dunk contest, because it's not just dunking that's gonna get you the win. I mean, you gotta get the crowd involved and get the right people on your side.
That is so true. And speaking of getting the right people, did they know ahead of time? Did you let Shaq, did you let Bob know that you might be calling on them?
I didn't let Quavo know. I didn't speak to him. I was supposed to jump over Dwayne Wade because that was my favorite player, but Dennis Smith used Dwayne Wade before me, so I didn't want to keep using Dwayne Wade.
So Quavo was next man up?
Yeah, he was just the next man up right there. So I asked him. He was with it. And Shaq, we spoke prior, but it was always like this thought process.
Yeah.
So I never really practiced the dunk over Shaq. I never.
That's good. Yeah, come on up, bud. How are you? What's your name and where are you from?
I'm Brandon, and I'm from East Somerville, Massachusetts. And my question is, who's the best player you ever dunked on? Like, not jumped over, but like dunked on.
The best player I ever dunked on, I mean, it's kind of tough because, I mean, now that I'm in the NBA, like, most guys really don't jump that much. So, I dunked on a couple guys in high school, but in the NBA, I only dunked on a couple guys.
So, you
can
look like one of them.
I don't really remember.
But your eyes are above the rim, that's all you see. That's a great try.
That's a good question.
Though. It is. I really don't know. Thank you, buddy. I love your breakaway with me. Your dunks.
It's been a while, but I am back home. That was just crazy. It was really fun meeting him, asking him questions. It was really fun, but just thanks to my dad for giving me a ride, paying for this. I never do anything without him. Thanks for Hamidou Diallo for taking the offer to go to the Basketball Hall of Fame to meet a bunch of kids who are really inspired by you, especially me. So that will end the video. Make sure you guys smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, turn on post notifications, Instagram, JamJuby12, Twitter, JamJuby12, yep. So yeah, make sure you guys like, smash that like button, smash that subscribe button. I'll see you guys later. Peace.